All right, welcome back. So I'm out here to get the plumbing ready. James and I have a game plan on this. We're gonna decided to lower this pan down 3.5 inches. So there's only 3 pads that we have to do. So we'll notch those 3 pad areas. We gotta trim like 2 inches off, maybe tops off the end of the sheet metal. And that way we can lower this pan in. The reason we wanna do that is when we pour this, let's just say to 4 inches, well, the coping for the whole pool was only 2. So then we're already 2 inches higher and yada, yada, yada. We could pour it 2, but then that would be different because all this gets travertine. So one of those things, we could have put sand. I thought about just even putting sand on, but it really is that easy. So that'll be fun. And yeah, so I'm gonna set up the time lapse when I'm doing this, kind of down in underneath here. And I'll talk more about, and I can set the camera there and we can talk while work and kind of show more what's going on there. Got a little bit more rain in here. All right, we'll see how long I get to work before I get interrupted again. That's the little magnet that I've been picking up screws and everything. Got that board removed, so that looks good. That's all gone. I'll fold that flat and then we'll just pour over it when we pour the floor in here. So I'm gonna add onto these and I'll run them back and I will put 90s on the end to run them up the wall here. Those will get 90s to run up that wall. Those can stay where they are. They're up high. They'll end up getting bolted to the wall. And the only other thing I've got to determine is with this, there is a backwash feature. So coming out of there has to tie into a pipe for backwash. So probably the safe bet for, so I'll have the floor drain back here. Water has to go pass by it, so I couldn't have them this way and try and drain into it, you know, going that way. So it would be like that. Anyway, so I'm just gonna come out of it and do a stub up. So probably the smart thing to do is to have that somewhere towards kind of the middle of the floor, and then I can just pipe over to the backwash, and that's probably the safe bet, like I said. So determine that for sure. So yeah, so time to get to work on that because everything in here needs to be done as soon as possible. I'd like to finish this too, but that's not as crucial. Well, getting the electric inside is. Good morning. So in the last video, had so many people asking, said I watched the video, but I still don't know what was wrong. And honestly, I was a little surprised by that. I thought it was obvious, but then Mrs. Beely Good last night at dinner was like, hey, I watched the whole video. I don't know what's wrong. I said, uh-oh. I said, we're going to have to go a little more in depth. So before I jump up there, see what we're having to modify down here. So, and this will also show better how this floor actually works. So see the floor, that bracket on the end just sits on the concrete. And then this has the little bit of camber in it, and then you put the metal pans slide in there, the little ridges at the top. And then as you pour concrete, the weight of it straightens the beam out and locks all that in. Well, we had it sitting on top. And even before I ordered it, but after the pour, when it was too late, I was like, I know we're gonna have to modify that a little bit, but because we want a 2-inch coping on the pool, and if the 2-inch coping sits right here, then that would mean that over top of the pan could only be 2 inches. We want all this to be the same travertine, so then what do? We need 4 inches of concrete on top of the pan. So we, James gone in here and notched. It was only 3 on each side. I say only James, it's only 3.
Yeah.
And dropped it down 4 inches from where it was. So now we'll be able to pour the concrete even with the top of this, and then we'll just put the travertine on top of everything and it'll be fine. So had to work that out and went ahead and decided to take the foam out at that top edge also, so that when we do our rebar, we can drill into the side and epoxy it in and run it all the way across and have the floor nice and strong. And then I'll show this a little closer. So this is a piece we didn't really have to, we didn't want to take out because of the curve, so we still got to grind that a little bit. But so see that little crack? We got a little crack all the way around. And at first, I assumed, you know what happens when you assume? I assumed that for some reason, this area in here where the gravel is, it had sank some. It's caused a little bit of crack. And I wasn't super concerned. I was like, okay, it's a little crack, blah, blah, blah. And I, if I've got any video of it, I'll pop it up. I'm not sure I do, but came out here and it ended up being a crack like a quarter inch wide. It's like, man, that's not gonna work. And I'd bought this kit. It's this high pressure stuff you put in seals, cracks and all that. And that's what I was gonna do. I was like, well, James and I were out here and I got to looking at it. And on the other side, it wasn't smooth on this side anymore. It was pushed out, which told me that this didn't sink, this moved. And James mentioned, what about that?
Stop seal.
Yeah, water stop, which is, this is the remnants of it right here. Pull some out. So I will pop up in the video where I put that in before the concrete pour. So the idea of that was we poured these walls first. So it was just walls sitting here, just like those walls. And then we kept the forms on. And when we poured the walls for the house, we poured this just like pouring a patio. That's all it is. Think of it like a patio. We poured a patio top, but we wanted to make sure water didn't get in through that seal. And this is a product that they use all the time. So we put that down and roll on like everything's great. Well, when we put rebar in it, the rebar comes out of the top of this wall and turns that way and goes into the walls. But there was no rebar from about this point on.
Drawed up.
Yeah, so that swelled up like it's supposed to if it gets water, you know, to seal it all up, the little, the where it joins. And when it did, there was no strength in this outside and it popped it. So we literally took the pry bar, which I just saw one, but it's gone now. You take it down there somewhere. Anyway, it's all right. We took a little pry bar and barely did like that and just took it off in pieces. James went around and epoxied in those rebar hangers, and then we epoxy, and then we've got rebar and everything. And so we're gonna do another small concrete pour, like 10 yards. We're gonna pour the floor of the pump room, which is why I'm working on getting that drain in today and getting all this stuff up. So we're gonna pour that floor. We're gonna pour this floor here. We're gonna put some in here and in that center part, but between the doors, we need a little bit at the top that was missed. We're gonna do that. And see what else I'm gonna do. Underground tunnel. So we go out here. As you drive through here, come up the drive. This of course will be all graded and different, but as you come up through here, the hallway is underground, so the theater's underground. This will have another building, you know, another set of walls on top of it. And because originally on plans, that was a separate little two-car garage. So you come through here, this ground will be up here, and you will drive over top of this. So when we pour the concrete for that, we're gonna go ahead and pour this concrete. So we gotta put up some boards up here so we can get the height we need and go ahead and do all that rebar. But we wanna go ahead and get this poured too, ahead of all this other, so that when we do our waterproofing, this is ready. We can go ahead and waterproof it and have this good to go. So that when we backfill, we can go ahead and, you know, put some dirt over it and kind of get going with, well, it'll end up being concrete over top of it again. It'll be another layer of concrete, but get this all waterproof so that it's good to go. So we're backfilling all this and everything else. So So that's what's going on. I hope that's a little clear. Appreciate the growth the channel's had and the new people. And everybody has some good questions and comments and gives me some insight into additional, you know, a little better, getting a little better shots and better things on film and everything. So I might have already talked about it, but that's all the waterproof and everything. So that's ready to go. So as soon as we have a couple dry days, we'll get that done, hopefully soon, because we're ready to get rolling. As I said, we'll get all this. This gravel actually gets pulled down some towards that, because this will be the clean rock needs to be 4 inches down from where I'm standing for the pad that goes here. Always something. All right, well, let me show the guys what we need to do down here. I'm sure they'll be excited, and we'll get going. All right, well, been getting a little bit done. Dug the trench. I'm let's dig 1/8. All right. So I'm gonna go get a catch basin. It's gonna go down there. I'm gonna overdig it, put gravel around. I'm probably honestly gonna keep the hole for that open. I'll lay some a couple sheets of plywood over it, so when drive, in case someone happens to drive over it, but it'll be all the way over there. Silt fence, I don't think so, but I'm getting one that you can run multiple things into, so we'll have the pipe, so we'll have the drain out of here, we'll have that drain that comes from the former drain on this side, we'll have a trench drain that's up there that once this retaining wall gets built and all that, that's going to come down through. So I want to be able to get back to that and access it and add more stuff to it, but not the end of the world if I had to do a couple of them, you know. So if I want to go ahead and get that one in so that we can go ahead and clear all this out of here and have the floor drain in place, I'm going to get a project box. So instead of doing another turn up, I'm gonna put a box in, run all those into a project box, and then I'll be able to come out of that and go to the all that's lights. So I'll be able to, there'll be little transformer boxes. So I'll be able to run out of those and from the project box. So that'll make that better so we can actually pull the wire. Because we get too many loops in it, you're not going to get to pull it. This is all done where it sat down 4 inches, so that'll be ready. We got to get all this stuff out of here. That's ready to go. James is welding up. We got another little short piece, and then we've got to cut a notch into that joist so that... See how these sit on top? That one's got to sit a little bit in there for that little tiny, it's just a little tiny short one. So that goes there. The guys are spray foaming. So everywhere you see the little gaps, all this gets spray foamed in the end, 3 inch down because of the radiant heat above it. You can leave them open, you get a little bit of concrete leakage, which we haven't done the floor down here yet anyway, but we're gonna go ahead and spray foam those, reduce the amount of water that comes in here during the rain, and it'll be ready for when we pour concrete. So that's what's happening. So back to it. All right, so it's another day, another chance to mess something up. So so the drain pipe will start in there. I've got to do that stuff. It comes down through here. Dug this out. Probably bigger than what I need, but it'd be all right. And that's where the catch basin's going. And so it'll come in the bottom. And then as that fills up, goes out the top and then goes to the lake. So we'll be able to tie this to it, and I might even have room for another one that comes off of there. Take care of that. So I need to clean this up a little bit and then have my trench that goes out. Let's dig 1/8 strikes again. I think Chris is gonna be proud. I would have liked to have finished all this before I dumped that in there, but I need that to dry out since we're going to be starting on that. So I guess we're going to find out how fast or slow the ground absorbs the water out here. Yeah, it's still pumping out. Dingbat thought it stopped. All right, so we're going to pump this out. That's naturally draining out. And get to doing our coatings. James is finishing that little corner of the deck. I'll show a little bit what that took. And James is, I don't know what I said. James doing that. Jeff right there and Tater are doing the spray foaming of the little cracks and stuff like we talked about yesterday. So everybody has something to do. Heading back, I need to go to the electrical store and get the project box that I want for in there. And I need to go to the plumbing store, pick up a few things. So, yay, yay, yay.